As a professional video editor, I love clip markers, and I love DaVinci Resolve, and I love using the index panel to navigate quickly for finding specific moments. But what I don't love is seeing a marker on all of my source clips' video and audio tracks. I just want to see the marked part on one of them, the video part. That way it's fast to jump between them on a timeline. Well, it turns out you actually can quickly remove those pesky audio markers once they're on our timeline by locking the video track so it's left alone, and then going up to the mark menu and all the way down to delete all markers. Hey, I'm Chadwick, and I have more of my little pro secrets and tricks that I use to edit in DaVinci Resolve coming up in episode 4 of this series today. Thumbnails matter, right? We're visual creatives. Now, how often do you get a thumbnail that's randomly chosen and it has like nothing to do with that clip? Well, you can actually hover scrub in thumbnail view with your mouse, just move it around, and then hit command on a Mac, control on a PC with P, right? And then it'll pick a new poster frame, you know, a new thumbnail for that clip or timeline in the media pool. Now, you can't really move the thumbnails around to storyboard it, but hopefully this is on a roadmap for the future. If you're watching Blackmagic, that would be nice. So to pick the best thumbnail, hover scrub, use command on a Mac, control on a PC with P. I switch between several computers each week, but there are a couple of user interface settings that I almost always change right away. The first thing I'm not really a fan of is the default blue background. Maybe it's there to help it stand out, but even if you're not color grading and you need a neutral background, I just prefer black. Well, there's an option for that if you go up to the Resolve menu, Preferences, User, UI settings, and then the checkbox for use gray background for user interface. After a restart, you can say goodbye blue. But while you're there, also consider checking the box for show focus indicators in the user interface. This places a thin red bar on whatever panel you are currently selecting. Okay, honestly, this is the best way to get to know where you're at when you work as much as possible with keyboard shortcuts. Shortcuts are not only page specific, but most of the time they're also panel specific. Personally, I drive almost everything with a keyboard, and you can pretty much do everything with a keyboard and work extremely fast. Ask me in the comments if there's anything that you can't do with a keyboard, and maybe we can figure it out together. DaVinci Match Frame is not the same as Match Frame to Source Clip. I didn't even know this until just a few months ago, but from now on, I just use Match Frame to Source Clip. Match Frame to Source Clip lets me pull in all of the original multi-channel audio that is usually lost on multi-cam clips because of adaptive audio tracks.
Adaptive audio tracks in this sense basically mixes down all of your audio channels together.
I then overcut it back into the timeline for more control on what microphones I want to use right there on the edit page. Now to back up, the purpose of a match frame, it's this button here. You hit it, and it calls up that exact frame in the source monitor. It's perfect to find what other material is around, you know, in that same area, and it's different than double clicking it, okay? And that way you're not changing the timeline at all. The default is F on the keyboard, if you wanna know. So that's match frame. But when you use multicam clips and you have multicam clips with synced multi-channel audio, which for me, that's super common for the work that I do, the normal match frame only pulls up the multicam clip.
And the multicam clip is only using that mixed down adaptive audio track.
So to get back to the source clip, which is the one that has access to all of the audio channels, you can use match frame to source clip. This is just one way to get around working with that kind of annoying adaptive audio track when you need access to all the channels on the edit page.
First, mark a clip with an in and out point. X is gonna do both at the same time for you, and that's the default. Then create a keyboard shortcut for match frame to source clip. I use N, but choose what makes sense to you. You're gonna need to reassign snapping to another key though if you use N. Now you can use N to call up the exact frame with the in and out timeline marks into the left source viewer of the original clip, not the multicam. See, it's the B-Raw clip. And then disable Video 1 track patching so that you can leave the multicam angle options available for later. Now just overwrite by dragging to the right viewer or using the keyboard shortcut F10. The other way to get access to an individual microphone without doing the overcutting is to use clip attributes, but first with multicam clips, because you can't get to clip attributes directly, you have to flatten it. And my preference is just to flatten the audio section. So if you option select just the audio segment of it, then you can go up here to flatten multicam clip, and we've just flattened the audio section. But if we take a listen, it still has all the audio channels mixed together and sounds terrible.
Cap's nuts are a lot more.
So he has a lav on, there's a boom mic. We just want to pick one of those. So to get access to picking one of those, you select it on the timeline, you go to clip attributes, which should now be available because it's flattened. Command-Shift-C is what I use to get there fast. And then here you see all these channels available. Now this is set to adaptive. If we actually want to hear this, you got to change this over to mono. And just to think of microphones, they're going to be mono because it's one voice is how I always remember it. So I'm going to change this here to listen to, let's listen to the lava mic first. Hit okay. And it redrew.
Cap's nuts are a lot more usable.
And if I wanted to try out the other mic, I would hit Command-Shift-C real quick to go choose the boom mic. It takes a second for the cache to redraw.
Cap's nuts are a lot more usable for this.
So that sounds way better to me. So that's how you can switch between the different microphones. And also, because you have broken this out here, another thing you can do is hold Option Shift and you get another copy of it down here on the timeline. And you can see, actually, we got more metadata information as that redrew to see that that's the boom mic. If I go to this one here, Command-Shift-C, change this one to the lav, we have that microphone available there.
Leave a like if you learned anything new today. And because there is so much more to learn, I'll see you in the next video.